Hi guys, in this video I will talk about how export is controlled in an Alpha system. Export, that means how much is fed into the grid when we have surplus electricity, meaning we are producing more than we use in the solar system. That can happen a lot, especially in the middle of the day. So what happens to that surplus electricity? In most systems, we do not want that surplus electricity to go back to the grid, so we want to stop export. We want to have export control and stop it. This actually Alpha systems can do inherent in the system. You don't need any surplus equipment, special equipment. You just integrated into the Alpha system, actually the export control. So I'll show you here. This is a day where we started without export control, and we started export control around 11 o'clock. Let's start with looking at the PV production. A normal curve of a PV starts low in the morning, goes very high in the middle of the day, and then goes low. Now, we activated export control here. So suddenly we see that around this time, the system starts adjusting the PV that it's giving out to the load. Okay, because it's normally on a PV production curve, you will see it flatten out here in the middle of the day and then start going down here. But this curve, because we stopped export around 11 o'clock, it suddenly goes down to the level of the load. See? The load is the blue, so it's hidden under there, but I'll show you that more later. But the point is now to look at the dark yellow or brown, because the curve is normal here, and then it just goes down. That's the important. It will join the load, so to speak. So we say that it's the system is adjusting the production of PV energy according to what the load is. That is export control, because then there is no surplus energy to send out to the grid. So let's take a look at only the load. So you see the load here is, compared to the morning and the afternoon, we see that it's pretty much the same. It's a little bit higher here in the morning, but anyway, that's not the point here. The point is that if we compare the curves of the load for the afternoon with the curve of the PV, they are quite similar. See? That's the afternoon, look from here until the end, you know. So that's the PV and that's the load. There. So you see how similar it is? They are not 100% overlapping. The reason for that is that, especially when you have very strong sunshine, it produces a lot of energy. So sometimes a little bit electricity will slip out, so to speak. You can think of that similar to a water tap with a lot of pressure. It's hard to control all the pressure without letting out a few drops. So that's why that happens. But the point of export control is not to stop everything 100%. It's to stop it, and so that overall what we call the net production is adjusted to the load, that you have a little bit export, like that's okay, because that will adjust itself. Because in the night, on all the systems we have, the grid always supports a little bit in the night. So even though it's letting a little bit out in the daytime, the net export will be zero. So the important thing to understand then is that when we are talking about export here, we are not talking about the special situation that happens in a power cut. Then we have another function that's not letting electricity go out to the grid at all. Okay? So that's a safety feature when there is a power cut, but that is a completely different function. It's important not to confuse these two functions. They are completely different. So export control, when you do not have a power cut, when you have normal operation, that is called export control. And when you have a power cut, the inverter shuts down. That's a safety feature. That's not export control. Or that's not normally what we refer to when we use the word export control.